Welcome back. Notify Boston, the official Twitter account of the Boston mayor, has released an updated visual of crime scene perimeter. It shows the extent of the area that's been secured by authorities. Ryan posted this photo after one of his lifelong friends, who is in a red shirt, finished the marathon 10 minutes before the first bomb exploded. Mark also posted this photo of a group of runners stopped by authorities and were advised not to proceed with the race. When he posted this, he had no real idea of what was happening. But singer Joey McIntyre did. He tweeted, "There was an explosion by the finish line about 5 minutes after he finished. He says he's okay, but is worried that many were hurt." Running rider Jim Gerwick said that he was in their press room when he heard two loud bombs outside, or booms rather, followed by a lockdown. He says that there were already reports of two bombs at the finish line. Running rider Tish Hamilton also took to Twitter, saying that she saw everything happen before her, but she says she turned and ran the other way. Vine, the short-form social media video app, also spread the word about the Boston Marathon bomb horror. A post by Doug has gone viral and is now a top trending topic, not only on Twitter, but also on Vine. The Vine showed the initial bomb blast playing over and over. There were also vines from Johnny KC showing the ambulances outside their hotel, as well as from Pablo, who can only say that the bombing was horrible. And finally, we have this post from Pinot, which shows Boston Marathon now trending on Vine. Various special pages have been put up as people were on the lookout for information on the Boston Marathon explosions. On Reddit, a volunteer from the marathon put up an Ask Me Anything or AMA thread, sharing his story while he was stationed near the finish line, the area of the blast, and helped out with the emergency response. The Redditor was with a friend a block from the finish line where they heard the blast. The unnamed Redditor adds that policemen near them sprinted towards the finish line to put up barricades on the way. The AMA has over 1,700 comments now, and in keeping with Reddit's rules, the race volunteer posted the ID for the marathon as proof. Still on Reddit, the site now has 4 live update threads on the latest news and information on the Boston blasts, and Redditors are cautioning other users not to put speculative information to avoid clogging the thread. Meanwhile, YouTube has put up its own spotlight page containing videos from American news organizations and U.S. government channels about the Boston explosions. Google has a special person finder page for the Boston explosions as well. It directs to 2 links, one that lets users register their missing loved ones and another that allows users to give information on a missing person who's already been found. Celebrities and top athletes were online to express anger and grief over the blasts during the Boston Marathon. While watching the news, Simon Cowell tweeted, "Horrendous. Please God, no more bombs. Stay safe, America." Pop star Nicki Minaj says that her heart goes out to everyone who woke up this morning to enjoy a peaceful marathon, but were met with senseless destructions. Here's what Ellen DeGeneres wrote, "Let's all send our thoughts, our prayers, and our energy to the people injured in Boston." Olympic gold medalist Ali Raisman lamented how hard everyone trained for this special day and now it's ruined. She adds that she's dedicating a performance tonight to everyone affected by the horrible tragedy. Miami Heat superstar LeBron James was also online and he says prayers go out to those involved and to those who were hurt. He also asked, "What is wrong with some people?" Pau Gasol of the LA Lakers was also shocked and sad to hear about the explosions. "There are things that I will never understand," he says. Mike Tyson also says that he's praying for everyone at the Boston Marathon. While Andy Roddick tweets, he hates hearing stories like this senseless act. And finally, we have this article from ESPN Boston about former New England Patriots offensive lineman Joe Andruzzi. He was at the finish line of the Boston Marathon when 2 explosions killed at least 3 people. Andruzzi, who played on New England's 3 Super Bowl championship teams, was seen carrying a woman near the scene of the explosions. Now, aside from Google, other sites have been put up for those tracking their friends and family from the Boston Marathon. One such website is the American Red Cross, which has a special page called Safe and Well. Users can list themselves as safe, complete with pertinent information and a special message, while another links users to registrants of the list. Another service is the Race Day website if you're looking for runners who checked in after finishing the race. Meanwhile, the FBI has set up an 1800 line for information on the blasts. FBI stresses that no piece of information or detail is too small. The Boston Globe is also calling on Boston marathoners who may have been displaced by the blast. Boston residents can register with the Boston Globe's Google Docs spreadsheet, while displaced marathoners can register at j.mp/Boston Place to stay. Meanwhile, a Mexican restaurant in Boston is offering its place as a place for those who need to charge their phones or need an open Wi-Fi connection for free. And finally, Reddit has a thread or subreddit called Random Acts of Pizza that allows Redditors to treat others to pizza. The subreddit is now filled with free pizza offers for those helping in emergency response or even those who participated in the Boston Marathon. The Supreme Court has issued a status quo ante order against